Good morning, dear students. So today we will be continuing with our topic data miners, which we started in our previous class. So what we have learned in our previous class, just let us quickly read and revise. Okay. Now, what are data miners? They specify the range of the noun. They point out, indicate the particular noun that we are talking about. Okay. Those words in the grammar are known as data miners. They make the given noun definite or indefinite. Okay, definite means the particular one. Indefinite here means the generalizing in the common one. They also indicate the quantity. Okay, as I told you, they are also telling us the amount, the quantity. Okay, it's a quantity in numbers also, in the terms of amount also. Now, see, let us read it. Characteristics specifies the noun and points to it that we have already learned. Remains the same, that means there is no form, we have revised that also. Okay, and then there is only one determiner to be used with one noun, that also we have learned, and always placed before the noun. That is the thing, these things that we have learned in our previous class. Now let us read now about the kinds of determiners. We already started with articles. Okay, so we'll come to that topic. Now I just wanted to tell you about predeterminers. Okay, the first one that we are going to discuss today is predeterminers, which is normally placed before adjective or a noun and or an article. Okay, as I have given you an example, see here, she is such a beautiful woman. So here a, that is the article, a determiner, is used before a adjective. Okay, to express an opinion about the noun they modify. Okay, it is rather a small car. Okay, he gets twice the pay that I get. So here, which are the two determiners? Twice. Okay, telling us the number of times, and the is our definite article determiner. Okay, so this is the way we use predeterminers in our sentences. Now let us read further. That we started with articles, definite or indefinite. Which are the indefinite articles? A, an. Why they are indefinite? Because they are pointing in general. Okay, they are not particularizing the noun that we are talking about. So let us read where we are using A and an. As we have already revised in our previous video, you can just read this. I will be sending you this document. So you can read and revise where we are using A and an, and it does not speak about particular person or thing. That is why they are indefinite. We revise this also. A is used before the words which is starting with the consonant sound, and is used by and is used before the words which are starting with the vowel sound. Okay, here you have to remember the thing that we will pay attention towards the sound. Okay. Okay. Now we will come to this definite article the. Which are the places where we are using the definite article the? For a person or thing already mentioned. Okay. Suppose in a sentence I am talking about a particular person or a thing which I have already talked about in the first part of the sentence, and I want to speak about him something, say something about him again. Then I am going to use the definite article before that noun. See, this is the man I met yesterday. Okay, so here I have already pointed out this. This is used for the man. Okay, so that is why I am using the man. I am pointing at the particular man about which I have already spoken the day before, yesterday. So when I speak about him again, so I am going to use the definite article the. We also revise that it is used before superlative degrees, the weakest person, okay, the greatest emperor. So we are using the best singer, superlative forms, okay, as positive, comparative, and superlative forms of adjective. Now, before a singular noun to denote whole class, I told you again, the dog is a faithful animal. When I speak about the class 8C is very obedient. So when I speak about the whole group, then I use the definite article the. Okay. Next is, we use before the names of these things. Okay, we have read this also. Rivers, oceans, mountains, deserts, names of the train, name of the body parts. Okay. Monuments. Where are we using the? So these are the places where we are using the. Okay. For rivers, the Ganga, oceans, the Pacific Ocean, mountain ranges. Here you have to remember mountain ranges, not a single mountain. When we are taking the name of the single mountain, then we are not using definite article the. But when we are talking about the mountain ranges at a stretch, then we use the. Then deserts, name of the train, the Tejas Express, name of the body parts, Ramesh suffers from an injury in the left leg. Okay, so I have a pain in my she has a pain in her. So this is the way we are using the in the name of the body parts. Also monuments, as I told you before, only which is unique in nature, that is unique things. The sun sets in the west, which is only one in our world. Okay, dates or periods of time. Dimar is the popular film of the 1990s, the 1970s. Okay, so when I am talking about the year, a particular, his birthday falls on the 7th of December. Okay, on the 7th, that is the way we are using the. Okay, so these are the places where we are using the definite article the. Okay, now let us read further. Denotes the things that are near or at a distance that can be seen. See, which determiner? This is the other one. The heading is not visible here, but I'm telling you that it is the demonstrative determiners. Okay, which denotes the things which is this or that, pointing out in that sense. Okay, this car is mine. Those boys are not good. So these are the determiners which help us to point out. Generally, there are four demonstrative adjectives, determiners that we use. That is this, that, those, these. Okay. Now, coming to the next one, possessive determiners. Possessive, as I told you, it indicates position or ownership. What ownership? The ownership of the nouns that we speak about. Okay, see, can be used before singular and plural nouns also. Like here, I love my father. So here, the word my denotes the position. I am loving my father. Father is mine. Their house is very big. Now, if you see this there, this is also a possessive determiner in the plural form. So we are using possessive determiners for singular nouns as well as the plural nouns. Now, coming to the next, then we have ordinal numbers. You know, ordinal number, which denotes the position, first, second, third, in that way. Okay, so whenever we are using ordinal numbers, then also we are using, so let us see how we use ordinal numbers in the sentences, ordinal determiners. See, I shall meet him next week. So this is, next is my ordinal. He is the last man to help you. Ordinal here not only denotes the first, second, third in this way, but also the next, the last, the first. Okay, that way we have to use. Now, the next one is cardinals. Now, cardinals are denoting the numbers. Okay, like I have two sisters. Okay, denotes the number that says how many. So, in this cardinal number, we are pointing out the nouns which we can count. Countable nouns. Such as 1, 2, 3, 4. My father has 4 cars. So, we hear 2, 4 is denoting what? It is denoting cardinal determiner. Okay. Now, let's move further. Quantifiers. So, name itself suggests that which is used before the nouns to state its amount or its quantity. Okay. Which is denoting, it's indicating its amount or quantity. Like, each child is talented. Okay. Every human being is emotional. Now pay attention here. Each and every. Sometimes we are confused that when we have to use each and when we have to use every. Each we are using when we are talking about limited or definite people. Okay, definite number of people. And every we use for a group of people, like a group. You can say, like here, if I say every human being, so here I talk about the group human being. Okay, is emotional. I have much oil in the cans. Again, much oil cannot be measured. So we can also just keep in mind that quantifiers help us to sometimes denote the uncountable nouns. Now see, countable, uncountable, and both. Okay. So, which are the quantifiers which we are using for countable nouns, which we are using for uncountable nouns, and which we are using for both of them? Like many, many students. I can count the student, few students, a number of people, several children, a large number of students, number of a grade. So these are the words, these are the determiners, quantifiers which we use with the countable nouns. Next one is, which are the quantifiers which we use with the uncountable noun, like much. There is much rice left on the plate, a little, very, a bit of, a great deal of, large amount of water is left in the jug, okay, large quantity of. So these are the quantifiers which we are using with uncountable nouns. Now the last one, all, enough, more, less, no, some, any, a lot of, a plenty of. Plenty of rice is left, plenty of sweets. Okay, so with the countable and with the uncountable nouns, both we are using these quantifiers. Now let's read further. Now used to talk about something. Now here again you are not able to see the heading, but this is the next one that we are going to discuss, is distributive determiners. When we are using it to divide, okay, to distribute or to divide something or just share, so that is our distributive determiners. Each guest was given a warm welcome, so I am dividing here. Neither plan was successful. Okay, so here, as I told you, keep in mind each is for group or individual, every is for singular, countable noun. When we use either, talk about two things, okay, but indicate that only one is involved or one is used. Neither when we are using for negative our sentences. Okay, now moving further, the next one, which is our last one, that is interrogatives. When this interrogative words, the question words, WHO words, are used before the nouns to ask the question, then it is our interrogative determiner. Whose pen? Okay, so pen is our noun, and before that when we use the WH questions, question words, whose, then it becomes interrogative determiners. Okay, I hope all these are clear to you. I am sending you this PDF document also. Please read it with the examples, and if any difficulty, you can ask me.